Good morning. And welcome to worship on this second Sunday of Advent. A special welcome to those visiting with us today, and welcome to those watching us online this morning. Tonight we begin a series of forums on mental health and our life of faith. We encourage you to join us for presentations, prayers, and open conversations about these health struggles that are profoundly affecting our communities, families, faith, and the world at large. The first one again tonight at 7 p.m., so encourage you to come for that. Next Sunday at 4 p.m., we will be going Christmas caroling, so invite you all to join us as we go out and spread Christmas cheer with our voices. So come on next Sunday at 4 p.m. for Christmas caroling. Poinsettia order forms are due by Tuesday at noon. You will find those on the welcome desk this morning. If you would like to provide a poinsettia for our Christmas Eve services, you can fill that out today or get it into the office by Tuesday. We are looking for people to provide special music on Christmas Eve. Our services on Christmas Eve will be at 9 a.m., 5 p.m., and 10 p.m. If you are interested in providing special music for those services, please talk to Bill Grant this morning. With that, we are ready for our opening hymn, Prepare the Royal Highway. I invite the congregation to stand. I invite the kids to come up and play instruments. Thank you.
Isaiah speaks of our God as a shepherd. God will feed us and gather us in God's arms. Let us pray. We praise you, O God, for this circle of light that marks our days of preparation for Christ's advent. As we light the candles on this wreath, kindle within us the fire of your Spirit, that we may be light shining in the darkness. Enlighten us with your grace, that we may welcome others as you have welcomed us. Grant this through Christ our Lord, whose coming is certain and whose days draw near. Amen. This is the candle of hope, and it illuminates God's promise. This is the candle of love, and its light leads us in God's way.
Opening dialogue and most of our readings today are taken from the book of Isaiah. Come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. Go through the gates, build up the highway. Clear it of stones, remove any obstacles. Prepare the way of the Lord. Come, let us journey to the Bethlehem manger. Hear of God's promises, witness God's faithfulness. Sing with Mary, rejoice with Elizabeth. Let us fill our hearts with God's hope, love, joy, and peace as we prepare for the advent of Christ. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. God of love, you comfort us in our worry and our sorrows. You promise to restore us now and eternally. Sustain us in our waiting during this Advent season and always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Beloved in Christ, as we await the great festival of Christmas, let us prepare ourselves so that we may be shown its true meaning. Let us hear in Holy Scripture how the prophets of Israel foretold that God would visit and redeem the waiting people. Let us rejoice in our carols and hymns that the good purpose of God is being mightily fulfilled. Let us celebrate the promise that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will bring all peoples and all things into the glory of God's eternal kingdom. The blind receive their sight, and the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed and the deaf hear. The dead are raised up and the poor have the gospel preached to them. But first, let us pray for the world that God so loves, for those who have not heard the good news of God or who do not believe it, for those who walk in darkness and the shadow of death, and for the church in this place and everywhere, that it may in pure joy lift up the light of the love of God. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer to God, in the words that Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
The first lesson comes to us from the book of Isaiah, chapter 60, starting with the first verse. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness with peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. The sun shall no longer be your light by day, nor for brightness shall the moon give light to you by night. But the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun shall no more go down, or your moon withdraw itself. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of mourning shall be ended.
Thank you.
wait for the Lord, and I will hope in God who saves us.
This lesson is from Isaiah chapter 40 through verses 1 through 5. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Thank you.
wait for the Lord, and I will hope in God who saves us.
This lesson comes from Isaiah chapter 40, beginning with verse 9. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good news. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good news. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arms rule for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd, and he will gather the lambs in his arms. He will carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep.
Bethlehem skies, see, all heaven has come to proclaim it. Hear how their song of joy arises. Love, love, born unto you a Savior. Love, love, glory to God on high. Love is born, come share in the wonder. Love is God now asleep on the hay. See the glow in the eyes of his mother. What is the name? Her heart is saying, love, love, love is the name. She whispers, love, love, Jesus Emmanuel. Love has come, love never will leave us. Love is life everlasting and free. Love is Jesus within and among us. Love is the peace our hearts are seeking. Love, love, love is the gift of Christmas. Love, love, praise to you, God on high.
I will wait for the Lord,
and I will hope in God who saves us.
The next lesson is from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 through 9. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and the little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
wait for the Lord, and I will hope in God who saves us.
Next lesson is from Isaiah 61, beginning with the first verse. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense. And I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God. For he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations.
Complete joy, sing peace.
in God who saves us.
A responsive reading from Luke chapter 1. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
A reading from Mark chapter 1, verses 1 to 4. The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight.' John the baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins."
I will wait for the Lord,
and I will hope in God who saves us.
I invite you to stand as together we confess our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made.
for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share words of peace with one another.
We continue our worship with our offering.
Let us pray. Loving God, you feed us like a shepherd, tending to all our needs. We offer now these gifts in gratitude for what you have first given us. Use them according to your gracious will. Amen. O Lord, our God, be gracious to us. We wait for you. Dispel the darkness, that all nations may come to your light. Establish your peace on the earth. Join our voices to sing your praise. Comfort the sick and weary. Renew their strength and power. O Lord our God, come to us,
that the earth may behold your glory.
Lord God, be with us in our Advent waiting and beyond. Remind us daily of the hope and trust we can find in you. Help us to believe and to follow. Strengthen us when our courage is lost. Show us your light shining in the darkness. As we prepare our hearts to welcome the newborn King, bless our celebrations, bless those who are hurting, and help us all to find our hope in the Savior of the world. Gracious God, you call us as your children and comfort us in our afflictions. Bring patience to the distressed, compassion to the grieving, and relief to the suffering, that all may experience your loving care. Especially we pray this day for Don Preby, Seth Drumheller, Steve Trainer, Betty Slock, Leonard Johnson, and all those we name in our hearts at this time. And we also offer prayers of joy this day for the newly baptized. Today we pray for Kaysen and Carly Dickerson, who were baptized here yesterday. Bless them always on their walk with you. All these things and whatever else you see that we need, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Before we close today, please join me in thanking the choir for their beautiful music this morning. And now receive the blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. I invite you to stand for our closing hymn, and I invite the kids to come up and play instruments.
Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.